Hey, Dan here. I'm an ENFP, and I've been coaching ENFPs and INFPs and other NF types for almost a decade now. And in this video, I wanted to share some advice for younger INFPs and ENFPs. And by younger, I mean in your 20s.
I'm Dan Johnston, and this is the Dreams Around the World podcast. My mission is to help you become the best version of yourself, all while creating the most awesome life possible for you and those you love. Topics I love to cover here include personality psychology, life design, and building enjoyable location-independent businesses.
The first piece of advice is to learn to say no and learn to be more honest and authentic about what you can and can't do, or will and will not do. You know, when we are younger, we can definitely be people pleasers and optimists. And this is a recipe for disaster if you think about it, right? You want to make people happy and you're an optimist, so you think, well, the last 9 times I said I'd do that kind of work, I didn't get it done. But this time's going to be different. That's right, Bob. I'll get that on your desk first thing Monday morning, right? And that is obviously setting yourself up for frustration and anxiety and going to create disappointment in your relationship. Now, you might think you need to do everything that everyone wants of you to keep them happy, or that if you be honest about what you can't do, you're going to get yourself into trouble. But the truth is, the people around you would much prefer you be honest about your capabilities, even if sometimes you're not actually sure what they are yourself, so you try your best to be honest about them, and maybe actually lean on the pessimistic side. People around you are going to appreciate that a lot more because it allows those around you to plan for that and to anticipate things and actually go on with their lives in whatever way they need to do, right? Because here's the thing. Those around us who are similar to us, but perhaps 10 years older, like our bosses, they're probably smarter than us. I think back to when I was in my mid-20s and how I behaved with my boss, and I can see how absolutely frustrated he must have been in retrospect. How I thought that I was concealing things, that he couldn't tell, how I was maybe anxious about certain things or would procrastinate certain work. He'd see me in certain meetings and wow, you're doing so great, you understand all this stuff. And then the work wouldn't get done because some parts of the paperwork or other parts of the job I would just despise doing and totally procrastinate and not get done. From his point of view, it must have been so frustrating. And if I had just said to him, hey, I'm really good with this part of the work and this part, but I'm terrible at this and I end up wasting a whole day procrastinating and I don't know why and I don't know what's wrong with my brain, but I just can't do it. Could you help me out, or could you have someone else do this and let me do twice as many of these meetings that I do really well? Probably, in fact, 100%, he would have been ecstatically happy about that. And he would have said, that's amazing, perfect, let's handle that. Instead, I played this game where I kept that inside, and I tried to pretend I could do all these things, and just probably came off like I had a drug problem, or was totally irresponsible, or a liar. Instead of just being honest about how things were. Because the thing is, people can tell a lot more about you than you think they can. And they can see these things. And ultimately, when you're not being upfront about them, it's going to damage the relationship. And from a practical side, I can now say, as the other side of that, as someone who is, you know, the boss and who has a team, is I would much rather someone promises me 60% and deliver 60%, then promises 120 and deliver 70. Because that with 60 and 60, you can plan. And you can say, okay, here's what I know, here's what I'm getting, and you can plan the rest of your business about that. When someone promises a lot more and under-delivers, not only do you have to adjust your planning and you're maybe left with some problems because of that, but it's also really frustrating. And you end up wasting your own brain power on it. And probably your boss's time is a lot more valuable than your time, both in their head and also practically. So causing frustration for them is a lot worse than delivering a little less and promising a little less. I can absolutely guarantee you that. here's the other thing. By learning to be honest in these situations about who you are, you're going to learn a lot more about yourself a lot quicker, and you're also going to build up your self-esteem. It wreaks havoc on your self-esteem and feeling of self-worth to tell people one thing and then be frustrated and unable to do that thing and basically be living like 8,000 lives about, you know, who you are and what you're capable of and feeling all this guilt because you can't get things done you said you would do. That destroys your self-esteem. Whereas owning who you are and being upfront and honest with people builds self-esteem. It builds reputation. It changes how people treat you and it changes how you treat yourself. So if you start doing that when you're younger, you're going to save a ton of headaches for yourself and those around you. And you're also going to build yourself up and develop your character a lot faster than any other approach.
My mission is to help you become the best version of yourself and this is a very important part, create the most awesome life possible for you and those you love. If you'd like to go deeper into some of my insights on ENFPs, do check out a free training series I have as well at dreamsaroundtheworld.com/ENFP training. And that's it. Here's to you, your dreams, and the backpack you carry them around in.
What's in my backpack?
Right now, my backpack is a laptop, 4 records. One of them is Peter Piper, 12-inch, 3 Serato records, 2 needles, headphones, and 4 condoms.
My iPod, my wallet, my lipstick.
1 phone, the wristbands for the party. Let's
break it down.
Big never had one, but Kanye did. But he misplaced his as soon as he got rich. Puff had one way before he became Diddy. You see him all the time out in New York City. Q-Tip rocked his live on Arsenio. Buckshot was the first one to put his in the video. MC Search dropped the flow with his on his back. On the last episode of Yo MTV Raps, I'm on topic. I rocked it when it wasn't that cool. I'm grown homes, but it looked like I'm going to school. And as far as accessories, they second to none. Every DJ in the world had his records in one. When you in the club with one, you might get stares. Could tell a lot about a person by what's in theirs. All kinds of lines, all kinds of designs. And I ain't sure what's in yours, but my dreams are in mine. See, the music I make has a certain sound. It's not pop, so they like to call it underground. Can't separate music, it's good or it's not. Cause if Mariah was on this shit, this shit'd be pop. Now under means beneath, like can't get over. When you think the underground, you're prone to think it's lower. But ain't nothing low about this, my dreams is high. I believe that if you reach, you can touch the sky. So get on your grind and let your mind get to it. Put your time into it, and you can probably do it. And they say that all I make is backpack music. Well, I say, hey, all they make is whack crack music. New era, and I'm about to school you. Yeah, I got a backpack, but don't let that fool you. Cause this one here, been to all kind of places. I've been had skills, so I'm best up for greatness. Y'all do what you do, I'ma stay on my grind. I ain't sure it's in yours, but my dreams are in mine. And the game will change, so recognize the signs. I ain't sure it's in yours, but my dreams are in mine. Y'all do what you do, I'ma stay on my grind. I ain't sure it's in yours, but my dreams are in mine. Matter of fact, Drake, run that back. Welcome to the $1 million backpack.